For today's video, we are testing the 5.5 kilowatt SRNE brand hybrid on-grid off-grid inverter with 300 Ah 51.2 volts leodar lithium battery. This setup is bound to masbate. 5.5 kilowatt 48 volts SRNE hybrid on-grid off-grid inverter. This preassembled cost 72,000 pesos. This inverter has 5 years manufacturer's warranty. This inverter is rated IP65 rating with the external fan cooling system para sa kanyang heatsink, and compatible din ito sa mga lifepo4 lithium battery. Bali ito yung battery breaker natin from battery to inverter. This is rated 125 amps DC breaker mccb type, and ito yung bagong ano namin design sa AC input output. Ano nga tawag nito, no? Ito? Terminal block. 100 amps rating yan, heavy duty. Para madali na lang yung pag-connect nyo dito sa taas ng AC output ninyo at saka yung AC input from the grid. Bali, ito may label. Grid AC input. Saka may label naman yan na line at saka neutral doon sa likod. Then ito yung AC output ng inverter natin. Then ito yung PV cable. Ito positive, ito negative. Yung mga protection device natin dito, meron tayong external ATS-MTS. Ito, manual mode at saka auto mode. Pag nasa manual mode siya, pwede siya ipihit manually. Yan, solar. Yan, manual. Okay, auto mode. Ito, PV breaker natin, DC breaker. Ito, DC source protection device. Ito yung AC breaker natin, AC input, AC output. AC input, AC output. Saka, meron din tayong AC over and under voltage protection sa AC input, AC output. Ang purpose nito, may current limiting function ito para iwas overload yung inverter natin. I-set namin ito mamaya to the max of maybe 23 amps. Ito yung voltage protection sa AC input din para protected yung inverter natin in case over voltage yung grid or mag under voltage. Ito yung AC SPD natin, AC source protection device. So ito yung battery input niya, PV input. Dito yung AC input, AC output. Ito yung battery cable natin. So testing natin ito mamaya. Testing and commissioning of the leodar lithium battery and the 5.5 kilowatt SRNE hybrid inverter. The first to on in the system is the battery. The switch can be found at the top, the back. That's the switch. Okay. And that's the BMS communication cable. Then if the battery is turned on, the battery data, it reads 52.84 volts. The state of charge is 46.55%. If the battery is turned on, the next to on is the battery breaker. Be sure that the polarity of the battery cable are correct. Positive to positive, then negative to negative. Then if the battery breaker is turned on, switch on the power button of the inverter. And let's wait for the LCD display to lights up. And let's wait for the inverter to detect our battery. Okay. Now the inverter detects our battery. Let's find the manual. Let's set the parameter settings of the inverter. Let's go to 01 settings. 01, PV first. Oh, tama no? PV first. Set to PV first. DT first. PV. Yan. Okay. Then out 02 is the output frequency. Change the frequency to 60 Hz. Okay, 60 Hz. AC input voltage number 3, UPS, it's okay. And then number 4, battery to main. When the parameter, the battery voltage is lower than the set value, and the output is switched from inverter to main power. So ito yung low voltage disconnect niya. Lagay natin na 48 volts. Set to 48 volts. Pag nag-grid na yung battery natin sa 48 volts, automatic yan mag-transfer from battery power to grid power. Then the number 5 settings is the mains to battery. Number 5, direct connect voltage from battery power to, from grid power to solar power. 52 volts. This means na pag next day, pag nag-charge na yung solar panel natin at tumaas na yung battery voltage, mag-automatic transfer yung system from grid power to solar power again. Then number 6, charging mode tayo. Charging mode is PB only. Number PB, choose PB only. Hindi. PB only lang na yan. Only PB. Then 7 tayo. Maximum charging current, lagay mo 80 amps. That's the allowed charging current of our lithium panel. Then number 8 tayo, battery type. Punta tayo sa LFP. LFP, yes, L16 kasi naka 16S. Yan, enter. Tapos, LFP, okay, good detected. Sa 9 tayo, boost voltage. Automatic naman yan. Then 10, maximum boost duration. 120 default, okay. 11, float charge voltage. Okay naman yan, over discharge voltage. Yung chug, over discharge voltage. Over discharge voltage. Isa't binang saan? 47. Test lang kung mag-change siya. Oh, 47.2. Okay. Okay. So sa 13 tayo, over discharge delay time 30 seconds o kanyan. Battery under voltage 14. Battery under voltage alarm point 48. Siguro mga 49 lang. Lagyan sa 49. Balik 49.2. Okay. Tapos battery discharge limit voltage default is 40 volts. So 15. Battery discharge limit voltage. Lagyan mo 46. 46 lang. Yan na yung minimum. Mm. Sige, okay na. 16 tayo, equalization charge.
Sige, wala na 16
lang. 22, diretso na sa 22. Okay, kasi lithium. Eco mode.
Disable.
Yung eco mode, yung eco mode is enabled. If the load is below 50 watts, the inverter output is delayed for 5 minutes. I-disable lang yun, para kahit maliit lang yung load nila, igagana pa rin yung inverter. Enable din yung auto overload, automatic restart. Then 24.
23
enable. Enable. 24. Auto restart, enable din. 25, buzzer alarm, enable. 26, mode change reminder, pwede rin enable. 27, inverter overload bypass, enable. Current of this, current of charging under grid electricity. I-set mo na sa pinaka-minimum. Pinaka-mababa. Ayan, 5 amps lang. 29. Ayan, yung sa address ng ano. Choose 33 item ID. Hindi lang. Ah, sa 33 pala tayo, no? Sa 30 pa lang. Ano yung default dyan?
1.
Ah, sige, sa 1 lang. Kasi wala naman tayong RS45. Wala naman tayong ginagawa dun. O, 1 lang. Tapos 30, 31. Ano sunod? 32. SLA. Enter din, no? Choose. BMS. Sige pa. SLA. O, BMS. Enter. Tapos 33. Choose 33. Ayan. Wow. Pile. Hanapin mo yung pile lang. Pile on tech. Vol. Pow. Ayan. Enter. Okay. Okay na lang. Okay na yan. I-check mo. I-check.
Dapat nakakas ulit kung nalaw siya. Ang kasi na sila. Wala. Diba ito?
Sa...
Dapat ito. Sige ito.
32?
Dapat ito sa SD.
Sa data set?
Hindi. Nalaw siya kung nakalimis. Dati kasi dito atong umarap.
Oh, sige. Try mo. Enter. LFP. Balik tayo sa ano, sa 33. Check natin kung naka-pile. Okay, andyan sa pile on tech. Okay, good. 34. PB grid connected power generation function. Disable lang. Yan. Yung PB grid, kung nag-export tayo, enable to. Pero hindi naman. Battery under recovery, voltage recovery point. Yung sabi mo na, no? Yung magcha-charge siya. Kasi pag hindi niya ma-reach yan, hindi siya mag-charge.
Taasan.
So, ano dapat?
Iba dapat 56.
So, mga 53?
53 o na.
Sige. 53.2 lang. 53.2. Ano nga setting ito? Battery and under voltage cover point. Okay. Kasi pag masyadong babaan yan, yung PV natin, dun pa siya mag-charge. So, ma-reach niya yung battery under voltage recovery point. 37. 37 tayo. Battery recharge recovery point. Baka ito yun. Battery under voltage recovery point. Tapos 37, battery recharge recovery point. After the battery is fully charged, the inverter will stop charging. And when the battery voltage is lower than this value, the inverter will resume charging. Ah, dito yan, sa 37. Yung namin natin kanina is 37 pala yun. Yung 35, when the battery is under voltage, the battery voltage should be greater than this set value to restore the inverter AC output of the battery and the set range is 44 to 54 volts. Yung sa 37, battery recharge recovery point, yun yung 53. Okay na yun, yung 37. 38 AC output, rated voltage. 230, okay na yan. 40. Ah, wala na yan. 6 yung charge time. Ah, sa grid na to. Kung enable mo yung ano. Set range is 6 yung 1, start charging time. Okay na lahat. 46. Sectional charging function. After the section charging function is enabled, the power supply mode will change to VT battery first. And system will enable this means power charging only. Ah, is it grid charging? And the set charging period of the battery over discharge. Ano tayo? 53? Sectional discharge function. Okay, disabled. 56. Leakage protection function. I-enable mo siguro yung 56. Enable leakage protection. Disable. Sige. Ano pa? 57. Wala nang 57 dito. Sige pa ba? Sige pa? Baka may tape pa? Ah, wala na? Okay. So, the inverter is... parameter settings are already set. And the inverter detects our battery. Now, ano yung testing natin dito? Output. It turn on yung AC output breaker. Then, may voltage tester ka, no? Or live tester. Ito na yung live tester natin. Ito pa. Baka basta mag-ilaw lang yung AC output niya. Eh, di ba, ilaw naman yung ano voltage protection device na. Ah, sige, paset na lang, no? Iset mo siya sa 23 ampere. 23 amps. Set the maximum discharge current of the AC output of the inverter to 25 amperes para iwas overload yung inverter natin. 23. Okay. Maset na yun, no? Maset na? Tapos, check na ulit. Parang iba yung function ng bagong voltage protection natin. I-check lang natin kung nakap 23. Ayan, okay. Ayos.
Ayan,
yung unang model, pagtapos ng set, pusa na mamatay yung ano. Okay. Turning on the AC input power from the grid. And our inverter detects the grid power. Saan yung voltage ng grid power natin? Ito, yung taas. Ito yung grid voltage. Oh, so nag-read na siya ng 1.7 amps. Okay, grid voltage, inverter output voltage, ito yung PV voltage, battery voltage. Yung 1.7 amps, yan yung self power consumption ng inverter natin. Yung sa dihinong, parang ganun din, no? 1 point something. May mga self power consumption sila. Kahit wala kang load na nakasaksak, nagkukonsume mo yung inverter from the grid. So pag operational na ito, well, hindi naman siguro mag-read yan kasi hubot siya sa solar panel at saka sa battery. So, tested na lahat. Yung ETS na lang, i-demo natin. Bali, ito, explain naman ulit. Nag-install lang kami ng external ATS. Ang purpose niyan is just in case na mag-fault itong inverter natin, yung system natin is automatic na to-transfer sa grid power. So, in case na nag-error yung inverter natin, let's say, yan, nag-error, i-off natin. Yan. ETS automatically transfer to grid power. And then, pag naayos naman yung inverter, back to normal, i-switch on yung yan, ATS natin. Automatic transfer. So, without interruption. Pwede rin natin i-manual yan. Ito, yung knob. I-switch mo lang sa taas para pwede mo siyang i-ticket. So, okay na lahat. And ready to ship to Masbate. Hanem Solar Products. Our store location is Roja City, Capiz. Your one-stop shop of solar products and accessories. Thank you. I-check natin yung ano, yung mga cells ng anong leodar lithium battery natin. So, punta tayo cell 1 to cell 4, cell 5 to cell 8, then cell 9 to cell 12, cell 13 to cell 16. Okay siya, then punta tayo sa warning, confirm. So, walang warning. Punta tayo sa capacity, and confirm. It's 300 Ah, and then cycle niya is 2, na charge-discharge na bruto sa factory. Okay, exit. Ayan. So, itong 300 Ah, 51.2 volts, leodar battery. 5 years manufacturer's warranty. Ang price nito is 170,000.
Oh. Ah, patsira tao.
Balik ka port, going to Masbate.
Balik ka mga panel po.